Hi, I'm going to show you how to actually do the images so they are unique each and every time. So I'm jumping on to photos.com just to go ahead and grab an image, and I'm going to pick the very first one because that's probably a very popular one that people pick all the time. And then I'm just going to download this just to show you that once you download it, you can take that and do some things with it to make it actually unique. So I'm going to take that image and save it just so you guys can see how Google works to start with. So I'll call this kitten. I'll save it to my desktop so I can find it easy. And then let's go on to Google and just take a quick peek at what we can do with Google. So when you're on Google, up here at the top, you can click on images. And when you click on images, right over here on the right, you can search by image. And so I'm going to go ahead and upload an image and go find the kitten that we just downloaded. And so now Google's going to go out and see if it can't find that same image. And of course, it looks and says, hey, wait, I actually see this cat. Look at all these sites. Look at all these people have uploaded this kitten photo. So it would not be considered unique. And therefore, Google would not give us any credit for uploading a quote-unquote new image. So let me show you what we're going to do. I'm going to use Photoshop, but if you had some other type of program, you could use another type of program and do the same thing I'm about to do. So I'm going to create a new file, and I'm going to paste that image of the kitten in. And so what's really important that we need to do, now this image is probably well, you know, we can see it was well used. The first thing we want to do is flip it. So I'm going to come up here to my layers, and on my image, and I'm going to say image rotation, and I'm going to flip it horizontally. Now, doing just that doesn't often, work with Google, because, you know, Google's pretty smart, and they know that you can flip it. So a lot of the things that I do is I might take it and, you know, change its size and change its proportion a little bit, and maybe even just try to skew it just a little bit to make this a brand new image. Just as cute. And then we could put some fun quote or something on there. And so we put some little quote on there, something fun or something unique. And then from there, I'm going to go ahead and save this. And we're just going to try to see if Google even thinks this is unique. So I'm just going to start with that. And what you could do if you just wanted to even, you know, have a little bit more fun, you can come out here and so on photos.com, maybe I say red ball. And I try to find, you know, something that the kitten's playing with, right? So I could come out here and maybe find, I don't know, something. Here's some yarn. So maybe I go grab the yarn. Download that. I'm going to copy that. And let's go back to our image and we'll put that fun little yarn. Now I'll do the same thing. I'm going to flip this around. So that way Google thinks that might even be different and it doesn't detect it as the same image. We might kind of change its direction a little bit, and then maybe we even come in here and, you know, say, hey, I don't even want the string at this point, so I'm going to take the string out, or, you know, do some stuff just to make the image just a hair different than what Google's used to. And then I'm going to get rid of this white here. And you can have someone do this for you. It's not like, you know, for the most part, you have to do this yourself. You can have somebody do it for you. And so we're going to take that ball. We want that ball of string to look kind of like maybe it's kind of rolled off the page. Okay. So we'll take that, give this whole thing a white background. And then there's our unique image that we did just ourselves. And we'll see if Google will consider this unique. So now I'm going to save this image. And I'm going to call this kitten in motion display, you know, whatever you want to call it. Now I'm going to take that same idea and I'm going to go back to Google. And over here in Google, I'm going to go back to the Images tab and say, let's go check that image to see if that image is unique. So I'm going to go choose the file, give it to Google. And now what you're going to see is somebody else, look right here, somebody else has already, you know, kind of used this image and flipped it the other way. So this is a very popular image. It was the number one on photos.com. You probably want to, you know, go back to the back to get something that's not as well used, something that might be way, way, you know, in the back. So in this case, you know, we're not going to get credit for this image as being unique no matter what we did to it, because they already have similar images. So we would either continue to work on this image until we got it unique and until we think, you know, Google thought it was unique, or we would find another image to put here. So get rid of, you know, this kitten and go, you know, back to photos.com, find something. So go over here to kitten. And I would go way, you know, go to page, you know, maybe we go to page 40. And so on page 40, you know, you're looking for a kitten. You know, these images might be less. I mean, you just don't know until you try it. But, you know, maybe you take, and this is another good idea, you take part of an image and you just grab parts out of, you know, pieces and that kind of thing. So another great trick is to, you know, use video and take a screenshot of a video instead of, you know, using a flat image. So let's grab this image, put it in here. And again, we're going to try to do it to where it's a very unique image. So I'm going to make this bigger. I'm also going to go this way. And maybe, you know, maybe we cut off some of these kittens. And, you know, we don't want them to look too fake. So maybe we do something like this, right? So now we've got a little bit different, doesn't look the same, and let's see if we get away with it. Now, obviously, photos.com is a little bit harder because everyone's using that, but, you know, it can be done. Sometimes it takes just a little bit of extra time. So let me go ahead and save that. And I'm going to do the same thing, save it, and then again, we're going to go back up here to Google and do another test to see if it's a unique image. You want to do this until that image is 100% unique, and you do this because that's going to actually have Google rank you. They're actually going to attach your name to that particular image. And again, these are great examples of why you can't just grab photos.com or something like that. Here, notice people have already cut out this kitten from that picture, and sure enough, it's been used, you know, on a bunch of sites. So, you know, CanStock, Photo, Shutterstock, you know, these people sell, and they basically created this image by putting a bunch together. So, not very unique. What we could try to do, of course, is, in this case, say, okay, so this is the cat that's given us trouble. So, using our Photoshop tool, our eraser here, we're just going to take this cat out of the equation because he's the one that's showing up as not being unique. And there's other ways to do this. You could use the, you know, there's a whole bunch of other tools. I'm trying to just go quick to show you guys, but, you know, you'd probably want to do a better job than this. But just trying to, yeah, so we definitely want to do a better job than what I'm doing here. But just to kind of give you guys an idea how good Google is at seeing this stuff and knowing what's unique anymore. You know, you just can't fool them, you know, the way you used to. So let's do that. Maybe we'll make the quote a little bigger to fill in that white space. All right. And then we'll, again, save it. Not the best artwork job, but you guys get the idea. Try this one last time. Go back to Google. Check the image. And voila. So now what they're showing you here is, here's our image with these two cats and our quote and our little ball and stuff like that. There's not enough pixels in this picture for Google to pick up on this. So basically they say, hey, here's similar images, and all I can come up with is bicycles. Can't even come up with anything close. And it's probably doing it because we used the keyword motion when we named it. We said kittens in motion, and this, you know, probably has something in motion. So this would be a great image to use now. When we put this out on a website or on Pinterest or wherever we would put it, this image would be logged as unique to Google. Google would give credit to the domain or to the entity that went ahead and did that. So that's why you'd want to put it on, you know, maybe your website, your blog, Instagram, something that you're trying to get some SEO juice or some ranking to. So here you see we've created, and we didn't take us very long, but we created a very unique image just using, you know, our photos.com subscription, a little bit of Photoshop. You can use something else, and then, you know, just playing around with it till we get something unique. So hope that helps, and if you have any questions, let me know.